The old X3 almost looks puny by comparison, and that's intentional. The idea was to get a little bit bigger and grown up, because you have so many other products in the market that have that sort of characteristic. But the thing that bothered me so much back then, and I mentioned it to you, is the front bumper. It just looks so big and bulky. It looks heavy. It does not look butch or macho. I mean, it looks overdone. And the thing that I wondered was that for a 2011 model, why go down that sort of an antiquated look? Why go down that road? Now, straight lines and all is okay, but yes, the face of the car, it did bother me back then. This is the M package that's been added to this 30D, which means, of course, no M engine under the hood. But yes, a few sporty elements. So you've got nice leather seats inside. You've, of course, got this metal finish front grille. But I want to get back to that point about why this bothers me so much. Compare it to the 20D, which has the regular front bumper. And now you can see that this works a little bit better. Now, again, the reason for that is because the bumper gets broken up a little bit. You have this black plastic element that comes up here, makes it look a little more rugged and breaks up the heaviness of that bumper. Looks more agile and sporty. Just compare that. And I think that's a good thing because, otherwise, if this was body colored, which it is in certain variants, ends up looking just too heavy up front. This works. This looks a lot better. And, it's a good thing in a sense because it is the 20D that arrives first in our market. At the time of launch, you'll only have this available. The 30D will follow in about 5 or 6 months. So, of course, it will make it there as well. And it's interesting from BMW that it only wants to go with diesels on the X3 for now. And I think it will probably stay that way as well. All right. I said this one has the M package, so which is why the alloy pattern is a specific one with the M logo in it. This alloy pattern is a lot like what you've seen on the X1. I like it too. And here's the part which is interesting. Now, usually with a bulky sort of a design up front, you get worried about how bulky it's going to get at the back on an SUV. This one's not. I mean, you get to see typical BMW elements, but at the same time, and of course the surfacing in the metal as well, sharp line coming at the back. But this entire region is not looking very heavy, and the rear bumper is not too heavy too. I mean, that's a good thing. The tailgate looks ample, gives you the impression that it's a big cargo space at the back, which is true. And then, of course, you've got the incongruous tail light treatment, which is typically BMW territory again. Works well. The LED treatment works well, too. So, overall, the X3 looks grown up, looks butch, looks macho, and works as an SUV now compared to the old one, for sure. So, it's no beauty like the Audi Q5, but it's masculine and big. I know you heard me saying the 20D arrives first, so you're thinking, why aren't you telling us more about that? Well, here goes. After the 30D, the 2-liter engine did seem a little bit of a come down, but only so much. The fact that the other car also had a fancy M interior means that this one could have seemed really dull on the inside. But the beige trim is certainly bright and cheerful and is one of the options for India. The M package is not. The car drives fairly well, and while acceleration is not as punchy, the ride and handling are pretty much on par. Again, a pity that manual gearbox won't make it to India, so here is what will. Again, this is a familiar motor from the BMW family, and with this one too, you get that 8-speed auto gearbox, of course. BMW will launch both the 30D and 20D with plenty of color options, as well as beige, black or brown interior trim options. You'll find that they come fully loaded with features like a sunroof. The launch for both variants is at the end of August, but deliveries on the 20D will begin only after mid-September. The deliveries on the 30D will take some more time, as I've already mentioned. Big on space and status value, as well as reasonably ample on performance, the new X3 will create some waves for sure. Expect prices to be between 39 and 47 lakh rupees ex-showroom Delhi.